Hello, and welcome to my first in-depth tutorial going over the process of sculpting the infected knee makeup. To begin, I put a layer of cling film over my knee and then drew out the wound in permanent texture onto the cling film so I could see how big it would need to be to look like it belonged there and fit well. I transferred this process of mapping it out onto my sculpting tile by holding the cling film over the tile and penciling in my markings. Then I started to add clay, and just quickly, my hands do look a little hairy here. That's because I haven't waxed them for a while, so just ignore that and just admire how good I am at sculpting, which I 100% did all by myself. Yeah, just kidding. You may recognize these hands, they belong to the amazing Powdah Effects. Check out his YouTube channel when you get a chance. We began with monster clay, which I love, but Mark didn't quite get into it. He didn't like that it wasn't sticking to the board as easily as Chavant clay does, so we changed it up to Chavant medium plastiline. He began building up the clay in the area that we marked out, keeping it the thinnest in the edges and thicker towards the center. He dug away at the center for texturing and built up the skin edges around the wound, and then I got to step in and have a little go at sculpting. I noticed that the reference image had a really bulked out center part. I think it's a skin graft that hasn't quite taken. It's infected and the skin is dying. So I bulked up the center area quite a bit. I wanted to make sure that it looked like it was on top of the skin and not like an internal part of the knee. I added more clay around the edge of the wounds as well, so it would look a bit deeper and a bit more swollen around the edges. And I started adding in the smaller bits of rounded clay where the pus and meaty texture would be, next to the smoother skin graft area. You'll notice that we like using our fingers a lot as sculpting tools, but this rake also comes in handy when you start to smooth out the skin area towards the outside. Mark tags back in here and he starts to add in folds of the swollen skin along the outside and cuts into and defines the edges of the wound. He adds more texture to the pus area and refines the shape and size of the piece. Next, he starts to smooth out the skin area again using a rake. Then I tag back in and create the stitch indents and pinching using a technique from Don Lanning's sculpting class on the Stan Winston School. So for this technique, I push towards the wound with a round edge of a brush or a silicone sculpting tool to get that pinch and that indent. And then I smoothed it out with a stipple sponge around the edges and then a little bit of naphtha on a brush. If you are using naphtha, be aware that it is dangerous, so make sure you have gloves, a respirator, and glasses. And then use naphtha to melt down the inner pus area to make it look smoother. Next, to experiment with skin textures, I tried different thicknesses of plastic and a stipple sponge, but I liked it better without any plastic, so I tried to texturize the skin a little bit with my stipple sponge. My knee skin is pretty young still, so it's not overly textured, it is pretty smooth, but having it not be completely smooth in the sculpt does help with the realism because skin obviously is not completely smooth and flat. I went back in with more naphtha to clean up the edges of the sculpt in preparation for molding, And then Mark came back in to finish off detailing the sculpt, refining the textures a little. We added in some more skin creasing and then more skin texturing, which we found kind of tricky to do that day. Mark added a layer of baby powder, which enables you to properly see all of the detail in the sculpt as it gets into all the grooves and surfaces. And then he decided to add a bit more skin texturing with a stiff plastic brush and some cling film. And this is our finished sculpt. It was really fun collaborating with Mark and taking turns sculpting to bring this disgusting baby to life. And in the next video, I'll go over our molding and casting process to get an encapsulated silicon prosthetic. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you'd like updates on when I upload new videos, click here to subscribe.